Blackstone Publishing presents The Restoration of Man, C.S. Lewis and the Continuing Case Against Scientism by Michael D. Aeschliman. This book is read by John McLain. Dedication. In Piam Memoriam. Adrienne René Aeschliman, 1899-1981. Sapiens et eloquens pietas. Foreword. James Lefanu, 2019. The three decades following the Second World War were arguably the most productive in the long history of science. Within living memory, we have learned how the Big Bang brought the universe into being, how the first stars were formed, and how within their fiery interiors, the chemical elements were created by the process of nuclear fusion, hydrogen into helium, helium into carbon, oxygen, silicon, all the way up through the periodic table. We have learned how 4 billion years ago, a vast cloud of intergalactic gas and particles in that by now vast universe coalesced to form our solar system, how our Earth acquired its sustaining atmosphere, and how the tectonic movement of massive plates of rock created the continents and oceans. We have identified the very first forms of life that emerged 3 billion years ago, delineated the internal workings of their fundamental unit, the cell, and discovered the universal code of nucleotides strung out along the double helix by which all living things replicate their kind. And we now have compelling evidence of the details of the physical characteristics of our earliest ancestors and their transformation to modern man. This overarching historical narrative, linking our existence all the way back to the moment when energy, time, and space appeared, apparently out of nothing, ranks amongst the greatest of all intellectual achievements, permitting us, if astonishingly, for the first time to hold in the mind's eye the entire history of the universe, from the moment of its inception to the present day. The triumph of science, one might suppose, is virtually complete. What, during these times, have we learned from the humanities, philosophy, say, theology, or history, that begins to touch the profundity and originality of that intellectual achievement? The authority and prestige conferred by those insights has marginalized those other ways of knowing and, inevitably, the doctrine of scientism. Science is the only begetter of truth, has, in its several guises, become the common currency of the academy and public discourse. Epistemic scientism, the contention that the scientific method is the only reliable path to knowledge. Ontological scientism, the supposition that whatever is not encompassed within the domain of science does not exist or has only a secondary or subsidiary reality. Promissory scientism, the assertion that there is nothing in principle that science cannot explain, and redemptive scientism, the idea, as philosopher Mary Midgley expresses it, of salvation through science alone. These several variations of scientism entail, by necessity, that man is the result of a purposeless and natural process that did not have him in mind. Our seemingly unique attributes, the powers of reason and imagination, the moral law within, and the sense of self, being no more than an illusion generated by our selfish genes and the electrochemistry of the brain to maximize our chances of survival. Modern science directly implies that the world is organized strictly in accordance with mechanistic principles, writes philosopher William Provine. There are no purposive principles whatsoever in nature. There are no gods and no designing forces that are rationally detectable. Modern science implies, too, there are no inherent moral or ethical laws. Free will, the freedom to make uncoerced, unpredictable choices among alternative possible causes of action, simply does not exist. There is no ultimate meaning for humans. Modern science may imply that the world and ourselves are organized strictly in accordance with mechanistic principles, but it can scarcely be said to have demonstrated this to be so.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.